A United States congressperson says she is sick and tired of separation of church and state. Here it is.
The reason we had so many overreaching regulations in our nation is because the church complied. The church is supposed to direct the government. The government is not supposed to direct the church. That is not how our founding fathers intended it. And I'm tired of this separation of church and state junk. That's not in the Constitution. It was in a stinking letter, and it means nothing like what they say it does.
That woman needs to take a history class. The church is not supposed to direct the government. The founding fathers of this nation had many flaws. One thing they got right was that they were trying to get the hell away from Christians and Christian rule. That was the basis of this experiment known as America with a secular government. Let's go ahead and go to the Constitution. Congress shall what? Make no law respecting an establishment of religion or prohibiting the free exercise thereof. In an 1801 letter to the Danbury Baptist Association of Connecticut, President Jefferson Thomason wrote, and I quote, "Believing with you that religion is a matter which lies solely between man and his God, that he owes account to none other for his faith or his worship, that the legitimate powers of government reach actions only and not opinions. I contemplate with sovereign reverence that act of the whole American people which declared that their legislature should make no law respecting an establishment of religion or prohibiting the free exercise thereof, thus building a wall of separation between church and state." The reality is, it's Boebert. It's not like the Constitution. Is that surprising to anyone? None of these individuals like the Constitution. They attempted to overthrow the entire government. Damn the Constitution. It's how they feel. We got to stop contextualizing them as conservatives and start contextualizing them as what they are. They are criminal, they are radical, and they are bad for democracy. And they're telling you that. Jessica, thoughts here?
Yeah, absolutely. There's no quiet part anymore. There's no saying the quiet part out loud. They're saying it directly. The right doesn't believe in an originalist interpretation of the Constitution. They believe in radically amending the Constitution so that there is not separation of church and state. They're being very deliberate and telling us directly that what they want is white Christian nationalism in the United States. And we need to take that very seriously and call that out for exactly what it is.
Yeah, and they have significant hypocrisy here. While they want to regulate people's right to marry, all right, because they're anti-gay marriage or whatever they may be, they don't want there to be a law that says thou shalt not lie as a federal statute, or thou shalt not commit fornication as a federal statute. They don't go that far because they're hypocrites at their core.